This is a strange looking bird.
Well, that was good.
Really had the largest impact on H&F's freight operation. This little switcher and its two sisters had been pulling railroad cars since the days of the Frederick Railroad prior to 1913. They were sometimes hooked up in tandem. These little locomotives were designed to work on short radius turns through the streets of Frederick. At one time, freight was hauled between Frederick and Hagerstown, where we see this home-built freight motor in Public Square. This similar car, here with a weed sprayer at the Carroll Street Terminal in Frederick, was burned to the wheels in a grade crossing wreck in 1943. In 1940, freight business had been half of what it was in 1930. But now, the war with Fort Detrick and the Salvage Reclamation Center found the H&F short on equipment. So, this boxcar like number 9 was bought from the Washington and Old Dominion line in Northern Virginia. By the way, these shelters along the line add an oriental flair, don't you think? In Washington, D.C., this car was Capital Transit's 017. Mechanic Bill Sweeney told me that the company's president, R. Paul Smith, was on hand when it was delivered and exclaimed, "That's too big to run on my railway." But run it did. Never fast, but it could pull. It was the largest trolley to ever run on the H&F. Maybe that's why they renumbered it 1. The company still needed more pulling power, so they picked up a couple of locomotives, this one and this workhorse, plodding on until the trolley wires came down in the mid-50s.
The steam plant must be there, too, to do its share in the production of electricity. And the steam plant demands coal, huge train loads of coal, which are a common sight along the Piedmont and Northern Railway. It must be remembered how highly developed this area really is, and how fully every phase of its industry is electrified. Then one can understand why coal is required in such tremendous quantities that instead of unloading by the usual methods, the cars are pushed into a special machine, locked into it, and the whole car turned upside down while the coal pours down the chute into the giant maw of the steam electric plant, which consumes 30 carloads every 24 hours when running at full capacity. A sight like this, repeated hour after hour, helps us to visualize the astonishing demand built up by the busy, thriving factories and mills of the Piedmont. To carry its goods out and bring its needs back in, surely, efficiently. And that's the service rendered to the Piedmont Carolinas by the shining rails and the whirring electric locomotives of the Piedmont and Northern Railway.